Hey, dummies! We're bringing you an extra special Me and the Dud Dud, the Mr. Ski Mask season, Mr. Ski Mask show, with me, your host. Come on, right on cue, my favorite restaurant, Mr. Ski Mask. Look at my shirt, and Melody. There's Melody and the Dud Dud. See, Melody is over there, sitting next to the Dud Dud. Dud-dud-dud-dud-dud-dud! Look! The All-American Bowl? Is that what you... That's what most of my viewers smoke, because they're freaking stoners, yeah. Even though I'm nailed to the X.
Yeah. What's wrong with that?
Nothing, Dudley. I'm not judgmental. I'm a conservatarian, like Tom Bowerly shouts out. All right. I don't listen to NPR. I listen to WBEN. WBEN. Talk radio. Give me a talk show. I want to be the next Kathy from Williamsville. I'm pretty enough. I'm sexy enough. Like Kathy from Williamsville. She's awesome. O-S-S-O-M. Two dots over the O's. If Pamazon was here, she could agree and chortle in approval, but she's not here either because it's an emergency show. Emergency! Emergency! Oh, the freaking cable company left a nasty note on our tape telling us we don't submit. Like, the viewer must submit to my authority and my dominance. Like Blue Oyster Cult, dominance! Hey, Dudley, when I say dominance, you say submission, okay? This is like the freaking Blue Oyster Cult song. I don't know if you can hear the drum. Can you hear the drum? Hey, let's do a little piece of music here from one of my favorite bands, Blue Oyster Cult. Okay, now, Dudley, when I say dominance and you say submission. Dominance!
Submission.
Dominance!
Submission.
Dominance!
Submission.
Dominance!
Submission.
Oh, I beat that drum into submission. Ah, oh, shit. Submission is a tribute to the Sax Pistols. Sax and violins, my favorite instruments, because the exploited like them. You're the exploited working class worker. All right. Now, this all ties in. The All-American Bowl. My favorite sporting event. Well, in honor of the All-American Bowl, my favorite drink? Cola? But my favorite drink is cola! Actually, it's recycled wine, but... Oh shit, I got a bottle of that here somewhere. Recycled wine! Tastes like brine! Makes you feel mighty fine! So refined. That's filtered through the ultimate filter factory! Shouts out to Electrics! Rack mount processors, like, the filter factory. Alright, cola has changed the color of their bottle for the All-American Bowl. It's a special All-American Bowl. It says, look, can you read this? Share a cola with the team. The team. Because the team is what you cheer for in the All-American Bowl.
Wait. Isn't team like lemon lime soda?
Yes, it is. It's a refreshing lemon lime soda, team. Take one for the team. That's when you make your buddy bang the pig monster at the bar so you can get the one you're after. Like, say Jenny's at the bar, you want to hit up Jenny, and Jenny's hanging out with something that looks like the viewer's mom, and your wingman is going to go talk to the one that looks like the viewer's mom, so you can hit on Jenny and drink a Jenny with Jenny. And then she'll give you some recycled Jenny later if you're lucky. Oh, yeah. She autographed this to me. Best of luck, Jenny. See? Yeah. Very nice fade, intern. Nice fade, like kid in play. All right. Comfort. Tidings of comfort and joy. Comfort for the depressed. We're going to dedicate this show to someone who was very depressed. Mork went back to Ork. And now the show is just Mindy. Don't know how it's going to be just being Mindy. They were talking about how his sitcom ain't going to be on the air anymore. But it's just going to be Mindy now. Because he ain't on it no more. Because he ain't here anymore. Which ties in with something I'm going to show later. But here, this TV show is to provide comfort. close up on me again, intern. I'm holding something up, high and hard. Comfort for the depressed, that's the show. For it provides smiles and chuckles, especially to the Catholic clergy who love when I talk about them in my positive tones, because I'm always positive because bar camera, wide camera. I'm nailed to the X, straight edge, like Josh Smith. All right, I'm nailed to the cross too by many people who don't understand me. They don't understand me. I don't understand them. They don't understand me. I don't understand them. No one understands me. No one understands. No Pamazon was here, but she's not. Me. She could, like, sing that song because she's in the bad Ronald. But we had to do this emergency show, and we didn't have time to get our co-hostesses, except Melody, to show up. Show Melody. Melody showed up with Dudley. There's Melody over there. All right. Now, you know what really gets my goat? The shitty freaking bands that I hear on Knights and Satan's Services 98.5 FM that play like all the Justin Bieber stupid music. And all these bands keep really reusing this lyric. They got the, there's a song by this boy band or something saying they got the moves like Mick Jagger, and it really pisses me off because it doesn't sound like the Rolling Stones. And if Pamazon was here with her accordion, she could play Wild Horses on it, but she ain't here because this is an emergency, 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 emergency show, because they left a shitty note on our tape at the cable station saying we submitted too late, like the viewer submits too late, like many people I know submit too late. Too late! Na-na-na, too late! Na-na-na, too late! Too late! For glove! You're supposed to cut to the close camera when I did glove for glove! There, for dramatic effect. Fade to black like Metallica! Speaking of which, they always say, there we go, we faded to black. It's a song about suicide. We dedicate that to Robin Williams. Fade to black like Metallica, we dedicate that to you, Mork. Alright. Listen to Fade to Black by Metallica when they were good before Cliff Burton died. And listen to it in honor of Mork. And listen closely to the lyrics. And you have sympathy, not just for the devil like Mick Jagger. He has sympathy for the devil, but so do I. Too often, I have sympathy for the devil. But I have sympathy for the suicidal and the depressed. And talk to them, be their friends, and be there for them. And treat people with compassion and empathy and respect. And be nice to them. You don't want someone you defriend who's real fragile, they might just end up going on the big cosmic egg like Mork came from a cosmic egg. Dudley, you got a cosmic egg. Dudley?
Nanu, nanu.
Yes, live long and prosper. Make it so. Okay, well, that song lyric that I... That came first from Acacia song. Says, we kick them to the curb unless they look like Mick Jagger. Really? Maybe when he was young and sexy and David Bowie used to get it on with him. But not now! Mick Jagger looks old now! He sort of looks like the Geico Gecko. He's lizard-like. No offense, Mick Jagger. You made some really good records and shit. Like, Angie! Stamp my Guitar Center receipt when I buy a synthesizer! Huh, hey. All right. Hey, you guys. I'm still bitching about the lyric about Mick Jagger on those shitty songs on the Justin Bieber radio station. Well, they say there's another song where these freaking boy bands sing, we got the moves like Jagger, we got the moves like Jagger. What? The moves like Jagger when he made out with David Bowie, maybe? Those are the moves with Jagger you got, you freaking jerk. Form freaking ape. Can't stand boy bands! I only like girl bands that like girls because I like the Spice Girls. The Backstreet Boys. Nah, Backdoor Boys. No. I don't like, no. Well, we're gonna change that lyric from we kick them to the curb unless they look like Mick Jagger or they got the moves like Jagger. I need a good close-up on this. So can I actually move this in? Here he is. Look, here we go. Glare! But I've seen on a professional shows, there's Mick Jagger right there. And next to him is Charlie Watts. That's Charlie Watts. Great drummer, Charlie Watts. I'm changing the lyric from, we kick him to the curb unless they look like Mick Jagger, to, They don't get in our twats unless they drum like Charlie Watts. Now let's look at Charlie Watts' drum. I got it right here. Blue Oyster Cult. You see me now, a veteran of 1,000 psychic wars. Truly, I am the veteran of 1,000 psychic wars. The relationships I've been in, oh Jesus. I'm the veteran of 1,000 psychic wars. Or am I the veteran of 1,000 psycho whores? No offense to some of them, but offense to the ones who were. All right, now we got something really nice. We got something real freaking nice. I got a motherload of capacitance electronic discs. This is The Misfits, Marilyn Monroe's last movie. And I took the Facebook quiz, which 60s actress would you be? And I got Marilyn Monroe, of course I did, because I'm pretty, charming, and misunderstood. No one understands me. Come on, Dudley, sing it. No one understands me.
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 Why do you give a damn?
I don't give a damn. Look, you think I give a damn? Quote the Spurlack. There's his name up there, Spurlack. You know Spurlack is spelled? That's how Spurlack is spelled. The newspaper always gets it right. Well, Misfits. Like the band that everybody dresses up for and imitates at Halloween. The Misfits. Here we go. We got Evil Live. And we've got Evil Live, a different pressing. We got Walk Among Us. We got Earth AD. But this one is the one I really want to show. This is like my past. It's a legacy of brutality. And there's a great song on here that ties it all together. Who Killed Marilyn? Of course, that one, Where Eagles Dare, that's about Don Henley, Don Felder, and Glenn Freedom Fry, and Timothy B. Schmidt, who Mike Sijacki says sucks. American Nightmare, that's my show. Static Age, TV Casualty. There we go. Some Kind of Hate. And Theme for a Jackal, that's my mom, because it's patched out of a jackal's egg in the super duper parking lot. Should we keep going, or should we show a video? Is this a great segue for a video? Something nice and positive? Because in addition to the Misfits, I've got the Howard Jones 12-inch album. He's got 12 inches. He measured it. And I'm a big fan of Ho Joe, like Rick Napoli, who played a show here recently, and he's my friend on the Facebook. Look, new song. What is Glove? I'd like to get to know you well with my glove. Pearl in the Shell, like Pearl Finish, Charlie Watts drum. Show the Charlie Watts drum. It's a pearl. It's in a shell. It's in a shell pack. The shell. Come to Shell for answers. What is glove? Anyway! Ski mask gloves, everybody, every way. Ooh! Oh! Ooh! Ah, ooh, ah. Let's watch a positive synth pop video to keep the mood with levity. Clop!
Yeah, we have a song. Thanks, Dan, for having me. I guess you know this piano sing along. This is a song called Shy. Yeah.
Apologies to you, Mr. Napoli, if the frickin' intern turned you down before your song was actually truly faded out. Send me a message on the Facebook, and I'll make sure that the intern gets a good slap with the OJ glove. I like Mr. Napoli.
The intern won't be seeing anything from the Cosmic Space Egg or Cosmic Space Mushroom. Merry Mushroom Magic 102.5 Mushroom.
Ah, Dudley, your little Magic 102.5 Mushroom ain't very visible. There, we make it visible. We make it plain. We reveal the secrets. There we go. All right. I like Howard Jones and so does Mr. Napoli. I like Howard Jones so much I eat at his restaurant, Hojo's. Here's the Hojo Bank. And it's orange. And my mask is orange. You think that's a coincidence? Huh? Like the episode of Mad Men? When they're at the Howard Johnston instances? I'm talking to all the mainstream people now. Gonna draw them in, gonna lure them in. You fool, stupid. Why don't you get the mainstream people like you? Stupid, dumb show, stupid. Alright. Well. For some reason, that comes back to Marilyn Monroe. Because I took that quiz on the face mask book that said if I was a 60s actress, I would be Marilyn Monroe. And that's what I looked like in college. Don't frickin' believe me? Ask some of my close friends. I was pretty. Like, your brain is pretty vacant. A tribute to the Sex Pistols. And that ties in with, like, yeah, Beauty and the Beast. That's me, two in one. Like Aleister Crowley, the Beast. But I'm a beauty like Marilyn Monroe. He's a beauty! He's a one in a million mask! He's a beauty! Why would he lie? He never lies.
Why would Ski lie?
Why would Ski lie? Oh! He's right here behind the looking glass! He's gonna kick you in your ass! Oh, he's a beauty! And the beast. That's a great thing, because, like, look. It's for... Can I get a real close-up, It's for the Intellivision, which is intelligent television. The only other time you're going to see intelligent television besides playing Intellivision is when I'm on your frickin' idiot box, dummy-dum-dum-dum-dummy-dum-dum. With those sucker lollipops. Dum-dums. I'll take you to the candy shop! I'll make you lick my lollipop! That gets the mainstream people in, too. When you're DJing at the key party. And I ain't talking about the tea party, I'm talking about the key party. It's key to everything you do. It ties in with Worm Womper. Womp that worm.
Key bank?
Nah, key party, like in the 70s. Look at this. Womp that worm. Whoop, whoop, womp that worm. Whoop, whoop, womp that worm. That's my new crunk song, Womp That Worm. Inspired by Worm Womper. Womp that worm. Womp that worm. Womp that worm. I'm going to program the frickin' 808 after the show and make it so. It's going to be a hit. And you're going to like that shit. Because you like the crunk. Crunk punk. There's a genre. What, Dudley? You say something?
No. I didn't say anything.
Let me show Marilyn again.
I'm just sitting here with Mellows D.
Yeah, it's very nice, Dudley. She's very pretty, but so is Marilyn, like me. There's that nice, robust 50s figure. All right, well, I had to show this again because it ties in with the next CED disc I happen to acquire. Have any of you ever seen Chatterbox? I bet DLF has, and Sean Beard shouts out, "Hey, Sean Beard, you got this one in your frickin' collection? I hope you do. You have everything." Where's the close-up? I gotta show the picture. She's trying to look like Marilyn. And you notice there's a radio mic right there in a very special area. Because not only does one set of lips talk, the other set talks and it sings. And that's what this is about. It's about, it says, over here. She talks with her what? Oh yeah, she does. She talks with her what? Can I get a what? Ooh, ooh, blah, blah, blah. Mainstream music. Come on, mainstream viewers. Come to daddy. Come to daddy. Daddy. Come to daddy like Aphex Twin. Come to daddy. Come to daddy. Hey, cut to Dudley. Because I got to get a prop.
Hi.
Yeah, this ain't going to make you high. It'll make you go somewhere else other than the cosmic space pouch.
Ohio.
Ohio. Dad juice. How about some dad juice? Follow me.
Oh, yeah.
Drink the Kool-Aid. Ah!
Stay away from those thirsties, though.
Oh, those thirsties, yeah. I wish I could find that for the intelligent television. This is absolutely filthy softcore pornography like your parents made you to when they made Glove, Lady Chatterley's lover. Absolutely filthy. With the shit they would show on, like, Showtime After Dark, remember that? Or International Cable Channel 10, let's see what year this is from. And I'll tell you which one it was probably on. MCMLXXXI, that would be 1981. Yeah, 1981, Cine Artist GmbH, so it was made in frickin' Germany. Oh, oh boy, check this out. Can we get it in the camera? A seductive, beautifully filmed Glove story. Lady Chatterley's Lover is based on the novel by D.H. Lawrence Welk. Once banned for its sexual candor, like me, now considered a modern classic, like me, shot on location, like this show, the English countryside never looked better. The 20s costumes never more handsome, like me. Beautiful too, like me. Is Sylvia Crystal of Emmanuel fame? That's a good softcore porn. Is Lady Connie Chatterley. Her aristocratic husband, Sir Clifford Richard Shane Bryant, has come home from the psychic war. He's the veteran of the psychic war. Oh, this is depressing. Paralyzed from the waist down. Connelly dutifully devotes herself to his care, but her husband's bitter arrogance soon makes her exist a nightmare. Selfishly, he suggests that she produce an heir to his estate. He never dreams that she'll break all the rules and forget her social class, take their gamekeeper as her lover, but she does with passion. So he got hurt in the war and then he's cucked. Ah, Nicholas Clay in a powerful performance. Yap, 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 yap. She was born a woman. The movie's erotic scenes have all the intensity and passion of the novel and are artfully executed with taste and beauty, like my TV show. Yes, taste and beauty. That's what it's all about here on this show. It said something about the English countryside. This is a must read. It is a must read. Everyone should read this in high school. Or at least first year college. English Governess by Anonymous. Anonymous is one of my favorite writers. Anonymous wrote a freaking shitload of good erotic fiction. Anonymous is one of my freaking favorites. I heard he was an alcoholic. The Alcoholics Anonymous. But he still wrote great stuff. Got tanked up on wine, wrote mighty fine. English Governess is one of my freaking favorite books. Oh, what a boyhood this dude had at the boarding school. Every young lad should be so lucky. We should bring back Governess, like the fine local band, to be an everyday event and training up the youth in the way they are to go. It's a good book. You see this freaking book at a yard sale, you pick this up and you read it from cover to cover to cover. Over and over and over and over and over and over. It's so freaking good. Oh my, I could read some of this, but I would get banned. Oh my, oh good Jesus. I write, go with any of these pages and they're, oh boy, they're all freaking hot like me. Don't you want to be hot like me? Hey, where's Robin Williams? Dedicating the show to Mork from Ork. He invented the spork, because that rhymes. So it must be true. Because the next movie is called The End. I think that was a band from Rochester. Probably named after this movie. Let me put this in the real close-up camera here so we can see what's going on. It's sort of like what happened to Saddam Hussein before his head popped off. Yeah, The End. This is the end, my friend! I should have saved this for the last one of the... Could have shown this as the last thing on the TV show and it would have made sense, huh? We got 1 minute left? Well, the viewers, they all laughed because this is a laugh riot of a show. They all laughed. They all laughed at you. In high school, they all laughed at you. In grammar school, they still laugh at you. You have no friends. Nobody likes you. Not even Rosie Palm and her five sisters. They even laugh at you. They won't give you any satisfaction. It's like, where's Mick Jagger? You can't get no satisfaction. You will get no girly action. No satisfaction. No satisfaction. Not for you and your cuckold crew. And your own juices you can stew. And your mind in poison can brew. Because Ski Mask is more a man than any of you. And you know this is true. You have no life. I'm going to screw your wife. How nice. Follow my advice, you stupid viewer. And give up on life.